Good morning, students. Today we will watch chapter 11, Light, Shadow and Reflections, part 2 video. From my previous video, you all able to define light, explain luminous and non-luminous objects. Then what happens when light is interact on any object, can differentiate between transparent, translucent and opaque objects, and also to classify the different types of objects. Today's session plan. Shadow, to understand the formation of shadow, to list the characteristic of shadow, to understand the property of light that always travels in a straight line, to learn and discuss activity 2, 3, 4 and 6 from NCERT textbook. Let's understand what is shadow. A shadow is formed when light from a light source is blocked by an object, by an opaque or translucent objects. What do we need to see a shadow? A source of light, an opaque object in the way of light, and a screen. Screen is nothing but a surface on which images are formed. Let us see the different properties of shadow. First property, the closer the source of light to an object, the longer the shadow. The farther the source of light from an object. Second property, the shadows are formed opposite to the source of light. Third property, shadows are dark in color. Fourth property, shadow is always obtained on a screen. Fifth property, size of the shadow can be increased or decreased if the distance between the source and object or object and the screen are changed. Let's see in detail first property of shadow. The closer the source of light to an object, the longer the shadow. The farther the source of light from an object. This property can explain with the help of a diagram below. How does light form shadows? Students, closely observe the diagram. Light rays travel in straight line by radiating out from the light source. If rays are blocked by an object, opaque object, a shadow forms where the light cannot reach. If the light sources move to closer the object, more light is blocked and a larger shadow is formed. The wall or ground behind the opaque object is the screen. On the screen, a dark patch or shadow is formed. Let's see in detail the property of shadow. The shadows are formed opposite to the source of light. Does the direction of shadow changes as the sun changes its position during the day? Yes, the direction of shadow changes as the sun changes its position during the day. Let's prove this property with the help of an example in the next slide. Let's see how the direction of shadow changes as the sun changes its position. In sunny morning, sun shines on his face. Now this boy sees his shadow on the ground behind him. In the next picture, the same day, at 12 o'clock in the noon, when the sun shines right above the tree, where is this tree shadow? Yes, tree shadow is right below the tree because sun is right above the tree. In the next picture, in the same day at evening, the sun was behind you, so causing the shadow to be in front of her. When the sun sets, there was no light, hence there was no shadow. So from this different situation, it was clear that in whichever direction the light is falling on the object, in the opposite direction the shadow will be formed. Let's see in detail the third property. Shadows are dark in color. This activity is given in NCERT textbook activity 2. Activity 2 ask us to put an opaque object slightly above the ground in the sun. Observation, we see a black patch on the ground. So, when we put an opaque object above ground in the sun, the portion of the ground below the object does not receive the light. So, we see a black imprint of the object. We call this dark imprint as a shadow of that object. Let's understand the fourth property. Shadow is always obtained on a screen. This activity 3 in NCERT textbook explains clearly. Activity 3 asks us to go to a park in the evening and see if torch can make a shadow of the friend on the cardboard or not. Observation: we get the shadow on the cardboard, but if we remove the cardboard, the torch is not able to make shadows. Why? Because an object in front of light source always make a shadow, but a shadow needs a surface, that means it needs a screen to show up. So when we remove the cardboard shadow is formed on the ground or trees, but which is far away. For the better understanding of the next property, that is the fifth property, let's understand how to change the shape and size of the shadow. Look at the picture. If you change the position of light source, can change the shape of the shadow, which is given in figure 1, and size of the shadow is given in figure 2. Let's see the last property of shadow. Size of the shadow can be increased or decreased if the distance between the source and object or object and the screen are changed. Activity 4 in NCERT textbook explains as fifth property. So, activity 4 asks us to observe the shadow of a chair in a different position. Explanation: a shadow is just a virtual imprint of an object. It may or may not have the same shape and size. Its shape and size depend on the direction of the source of light, screen position, and distance. The most prominent and important property of light is rectilinear propagation of light. Let's understand this activity. Activity to show that light travels in straight line. Let's see the procedure. Arrange two pipes, one straight and the other bent pipe. Observe a burning candle through the straight pipe. What do you observe? Candle is seen. What do you infer from this? Light travels in straight line. In the second case, observe the candle through the bent pipe. What do you observe? Candle is not seen. What do you infer from this? Light does not bend. So, result of this activity is that indicates that light travels only in a straight line. Thank you, students.